गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, रेस्पेक्टेड जूरी मेंबर्स एंड माय डिग्नेटरीज, माय फ्रेंड्स एंड सीनियर्स. आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अ टॉपिक व्हिच इज वेरी लॉजिकल, इनएक्सपेंसिव, कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव एंड यूजर फ्रेंडली टू एवरीवन, एंड इट कैन बी यूज्ड. एंड दो वेरी लेस स्टडीज हैज बीन डन इन दिस लाइन और इन दिस फील्ड, आई यू सजेस्ट ऑल dental practitioners to work on this. It is based on toothprint, or medically or dentally it is called as amalgamics. And as we all know, forensics is derived from a Latin word called forum, and pertaining to law, and is discussing in between the public. Next. You guys must be knowing about the definition. I'm not going to discuss, but the main thing what I want to tell you is proper handling and examination of dental evidence. Now, dental evidence means whatever things were coming across through dentist or through tooth, that is very important. Coming to forensic science, evidence is much more important. It is when it comes to discussing about a case. And evidence may come like a print, tooth print, tongue print, palm print, fingerprint, and all. So that there we will evaluate and present the dental findings and come to a conclusion of justice. Now, tooth print or dentally or medically it is called as amalgamics. Next. Amalgamics means amalo means a part of structure of tooth, that is enamel, and graphics means carving. So we discuss the structure and orientation of enamel rods in various pattern, and we see the importance of toothprint, and it is going to be manifested as various techniques. And the physical properties of enamel says 96% of inorganic component and 4% of organic component, percentage by volume, percentage by weight, and percentage by volume is 92% inorganic and 8% organic. It provides significant information. And when we compare between antemortem and postmortem data, definitely we are going to conclude it, and it will help in person identification and age estimation. Other than amalgamics, we use other techniques like stroboscopy, dental chart, denture leveling, and DNA sampling, which are going to be used in further procedure. And bite mark analysis also is an upcoming and interesting topic what we focus. Coming to embryological component of enamel is derived from a ectodermal component, and it is avascular in nature, which has principal element called enamel rod, and enamel rods pass from these travels from DZ to the surface area, and the diameter of this enamel rods are 4 to 5 micrometer in diameter, and around 9 to 11 micrometer in length. They have 1:2 ratio dimension when it comes from DZ to the surface area. And enamel rods or prism varies its orientation according to the geography, according to its position, and according to its location. Enamel, according to macroscopical point of view, we see incremental lines of enamel that is manifested as perichymata. And macroscopical point of view, coming to thick part of enamel rod, it is seen on cuspal part, and thin part is seen on DZ or dentino enamel junction. Now, enamel prisms are having various patterns, like prism 1 are showing a keyhole pattern, or it is circular in nature. Pattern 2 is prismless, or prism are aligned in parallel row, and pattern 3 are arranged in straightened pattern. Now, patterns of enamel rods are either keyhole pattern or paddle shape pattern, or going to be seen as circular pattern. This pattern are going to be manifested clinically or under microscope by 10% orthophosphoric acid. And when we expose these with acid, we can see microscopically these patterns, same as like fingerprint. So it is very essential to know that we are seeing linear pattern, linear branch pattern, linear unbranched pattern, whole pattern, loop pattern, and all. So these patterns, you can correlate. Ma'am, stop changing. Yeah, thank you. So this pattern, if you correlate with, it is just an averring to every forensic scientist that this, if you correlate these patterns with the fingerprint and palm print, it is obviously interrelated and it is always mixed. So there are three change. Kindly change, ma'am. Yeah, there are three patterns. Techniques what we use to record finger tooth print. First is acid etching. Second is acidated peel technique, and third is automated biometric technique. In all these three patterns, what we see is utilization of 10% orthophosphoric acid. This 10% orthophosphoric acid will dissolve or demineralize the organic component, and it will clear some widening component of the enamel rod, near to enamel rod or adjacent to enamel rod, or you can easily take a print. As electron microscope of enamel rod sheath, it is enamel rod sheath or interoral substance. So by utilization of orthophosphoric acid, 10% orthophosphoric acid, we can see all these patterns. So it is simple technique, inexpensive, rapid, and it can be done by any dental auxiliaries. So it is just an evergreen presentation to every forensic scientist. He can utilize this. And though I couldn't get much reference about this concept, I use this to aware everyone. Thank you so much.